All right, welcome back, Sports Chat 503. Winter Olympics, my man.
Yep, starting up Vancouver opening ceremonies.
Right now.
Yep.
All fired up right now. We're busy watching it.
Yeah, it's riveting.
It's riveting.
Yeah, North Korea looks real strong this
year. Yeah, I like the way they all come in, you know. Yeah. Why do people get so excited about the Olympics, Bo?
I suppose it's because...
the world coming together, the unity, that sort of
stuff. I really don't think people care about that. You know, I think it's...
it's because there's nothing else going on in the sports season. They choose late August and February, the two dullest times of the sports year, before football season, after football season.
Yeah. Yeah, it's... I don't know. I don't know why people like it so much, but hey, right. Good for you.
So what's the best part about the Winter Olympics for you?
Best part of the Winter Olympics? I'd say I like watching... I don't really like watching any of it. I like hockey, I suppose, because of, you know, there's some NHL players.
I like
players
the hockey in the Olympics almost better than I like the NHL sometimes.
Yeah, I think I do, yeah.
Regular season, right, at least. I'm not really into the regular season. I like the playoffs, though.
And then other winter events, I don't know. I watch the skating, but it's not to see how good the skaters are.
Pair skating, right?
No, just men's singles.
I love the outfits.
Yeah, oh, it's the choreography. That's what gets me.
Beautiful, beautiful.
The I don't know, man. The everything else, like skiing downhill, long jump or whatever. I don't know.
Are you into the new stuff? Like, do you like the snowboarding?
No, I don't think it should be an Olympic sport.
Yeah,
I don't like it.
Yeah.
What about you?
Seeing is that I don't participate. My winter sport is basketball.
Good.
So I mean, and it always has been, so my time in the snow is brief.
Yeah.
But I understand where people are coming from. I understand the need to feel the world come together, athletic competition bring people together, the goodness of sports, the positivity, the camaraderie, the unifying event.
Yeah,
that's why, to be honest, I think that the opening ceremonies is the most popular thing of the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah, it's, I mean...
I think more people watch the opening ceremonies than the closing ceremonies, the main events, the main...
Yeah, it's probably, like, one of the only things that the whole world can come together on and not really...
fight each other.
Yeah, like, not really want to...
kill each other. Yeah, bring out the military.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I think what's interesting about the opening ceremony is that people love to watch it, but it's all it is people just walking into a building.
Yeah,
it's like a huge event to see people walk in.
And here comes a team from Romania.
Ooh, there they are. Look at them. And they get to talk about the person who carries the flag, and then it's like the next team. I mean, it's not even a parade. There's no float.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just people, and they're like...
Yeah, and it's wintertime, so it's cold out,
what's
man.
Weird is, what's weird is that they have the idea of, like, you know, you take your victory lap, right?
Yeah.
But this is before anybody's even done anything.
Yeah.
And everybody's doing a lap like, yep. Yep, we're here. Like, maybe that's the victory for just being there.
Yeah, I mean, a lot
everybody
of
everybody gets to celebrate being a victor.
Yeah,
that's their
participation trophy right there. Look, I'm participating. You won't see me anywhere else.
But I'm here, damn it.
Yeah.
I'm here, so turn me on. Tebow it. Okay, worst part about the Winter Olympics.
The worst part is...
have you already mentioned that? in your best part.
Yeah, my best part, yeah. It probably goes... Yeah, I don't know. What about you?
I think the worst part about the Winter Olympics is trying to produce a event that people don't know about, don't care about. Yep. The only reason why they're watching it is because it's on TV.
Yeah, and it's called the Olympics.
And if it wasn't on TV, nobody would care about it.
Yeah.
Unless you were a fan of that sport or something.
Yeah, you're totally right. Like, I'm sure most people don't know the rules or the scoring for most of the things that they watch.
Yeah, for example, curling. I remember the last Winter Olympics. Everybody loved curling out of nowhere. Well, all of a sudden people were like, it had been a sport for quite some time.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden people were like, what is this thing with the brooms? And
yeah, that's right. It's
like,
got all the
it's
attention.
Got all this pub. It's like, ooh.
Yeah.
Curling.
Yeah, here's a
hello.
Yeah.
It's so uncomfortable. It's like, it's like being at the dentist office and sitting in the waiting room with the person next to you. And you want to break the ice and the tension and actually have a human conversation with them, but you don't really know how long you're going to sit there or how long they're going to sit there. So you don't really want to get too deep
That's
so
right.
So you want to talk about something, but you also don't want to go like, hey, how's the weather? So you want to, you know, yeah. And you don't want to do anything personal. You want to be, you know, what are you here for or anything? You just want to kind of just ease into it. And it feels like that's what the Olympics is doing. They're trying to be like, hey, excuse me, after dinner, can you come in and just look really quickly at what we're doing? There's some people skating. Yeah, and then you guys can do whatever, you guys can go back to whatever.
Yeah.
We're just having this thing over here where people are doing. Yeah. And it's just so awkward.
Yeah, they make a big production out of it, almost like they're doing a movie or something, just to get people to watch.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
The news coverage,
oh.
You got like every news person that's ever been in front of a camera, I guess. Up in Vancouver, why is Katie Couric in Vancouver?
Dude.
Why is Matt Lauer, like, it's kind of sad I know their names, but, like, why are these people, hey, we're live in Vancouver, and, like, maybe a bobsledder's gonna go by, or,
well, what's funny to me is there's radio hosts who went up there, who were like, we're on the radio here, we're live in Vancouver, we're giving the inside scoop. Today, this is happening. Dude, you're not even showing anything, you're on the radio.
Yeah.
Now, I understand the reasons behind corporations getting involved with the Olympics.
Totally. Yeah.
Your market just opened up, bro, worldwide.
Yeah, globally,
For that moment, you can sell whatever you want to whatever, to whomever.
Yeah.
But to an average fan, guy sitting in Columbus, Ohio, guy sitting in Eugene, Oregon, guy sitting in Palo Alto, guy sitting in freaking Scottsdale, Arizona, any of those people doing any of their normal thing, the Olympics is so far beyond anything that they do or experience. Okay, perfect example is you and I can play basketball.
Yeah.
And then go watch an NBA game and be like, whoa, look at those guys play. Yeah. Wow.
Cool.
Wow. If you and I went up skiing and then watched those guys ski, it's not like, wow. It's not, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, you see them do it and then you see the next guy do it and you're like,
I mean,
pretty close.
Yeah, I mean, I watch like the trials, and they do the same run, and it looks exactly the same. And there's like a half a second or a split second, and the announcers are actually trying to tell me what the difference is between. He hung up that. Caught a little air on that one.
Yeah.
They're going like 80 miles an hour down a mountain between little things, and they hit the. Are they supposed to hit them or not hit them? Does it count if they hit them? Because it seems like they're trying to hit him.
Yeah, I think they do try to hit him.
I think it counts.
Yeah, they try to get as close as possible while still going around him.
But my thing is,
that means, you know, if it's here, you want to, like, literally run.
Are you count? Is it like a point system?
Yeah, I don't think you have to knock him down.
See, I was thinking you had to. Well, as a kid, I thought you had to go through him. And then I was like, no, they just go on the side.
Yeah.
But I think they actually try to hit him with the pole or hit him with their hips.
Yeah, I think they do that. Yeah.
And then they count him. They like actually.
Oh, is that right? Like they?
I don't know.
Yeah.
That's how I would arrange it.
And that's a perfect example of how much we know about Olympics.
Yeah, you and I think we would try to have some sort of point system to determine who got more, you know, who hit more of the targets or something.
Right, yeah. I guess that's.
Is it just speed? Who gets on the hill first? Or?
Yeah, I think it is. But I guess that's kind of the last little thing I'm going to say is that I think that's why I don't like the Olympics a lot is because a lot of it is judged.
Yeah.
Like you do the
Canadians judge gave her this and they're like just looking at the Canadian judge.
Yeah.
Like, how dare you?
Dude, that's garbage.
How dare you?
Yeah. I mean, I don't like that part of it. It's all
human element.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a little BS.
Yeah.
All right, Sports Chat 503, thanks for visiting, man. We love all the YouTube viewers, all
the
members. Thank you very much.
Keep
your comments and keep them watching, baby. Adios.